Hello, good morning everybody. I am Mr. Ravikiran Bhaskarav Patil from Dr. Tata Sai Purnapatri Madhyamik Vidyalaya Chaisgaon, District Jalgaon. My registration number is B075. My presentation topic is arithmetic progression. I explain the subtopics from this arithmetic progression in three steps. The main three steps are: first is the observe and explore, second is the define and prove, third is the apply and evaluate. Now we take the first step, observe and explore. What is sequence? For this question or for this sequence, there are some activities. First activity, see the pictures. There are some pictures. This is the structure of leaves. This is the structure of cactus, structure of flowers, and this is the pyramid. Activity second, see this table. In this table there are some columns and rows. In rows or columns or diagonally there are numbers. There is a pattern. In last activity, in the pictures there is also pattern. Activity number three, now see this video. Observe these numbers. This is the structure of animal. Look this pattern. How to create the flower of sunflower? Look these leaves. Look the parts of this flower. There is a pattern. to this insect and its arms, the flying arms, there is also pattern. In this video, there are some animals, plants, and there are some insects. There is a pattern. Now, next activity. Activity number 4. There are the collection of numbers. Write your observations. First example, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. Second, 1, 8, 27, 64 and so on. 3, 6, 9, 12 and so on. 0.1, 0.01, 0.001, 0.0001. And so on. -25, -23, -21, -29, and so on. Now, second step is define and prove. Our question is, what is sequence? From these activities, in all above activities, there is a fixed pattern. That means we get a definition, the collection of numbers in mathematically, the collection of numbers arranged in a definite order according to the definite rule is known as the sequence. Generally, the first terms of sequence is generally denoted by T1, second term T2, third term T3 and so on. The nth term of the sequence is denoted by Tn. In general, the general term of sequence is Tn, then the sequence is denoted by in curly bracket Tn. The sum of the first n terms of the sequence is denoted by Sn, S for sum. Sum of first n terms means Sn is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus up to Tn, that is S1 is equal to T1. S2 is equal to T1 plus T2. Here S3 is wrong. S3 is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. From equations 1 and 2, we subtract equation 1 from equation 2, we get T2 is equal to S2 minus S1. If we subtract equation 2 from equation 3, we get T3 is equal to S3 minus S2. That means T4 is equal to S4 minus S3. And so on, Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Now, third step is apply and evaluate. There are some questions. Find the next 3 terms of the following sequences. There are some sequences are given. Find the next 3 terms of those sequences. First is 5, 7, 11, 17, 25. 1, 3, 7, 15, 31, 128, minus 64, 32, minus 16, and so on. Like this, there are some examples for solving for the students. Second question, find the first 5 terms of the sequences if its nth term, means general term, is given. Tn is equal to 4n minus 1, Tn is equal to n cube minus 1, Tn is equal to n square plus thrice n, Tn is equal to 1 upon n square plus n, Tn is equal to n square into n plus 1 bracket square upon 4. For these examples, if we put n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we get t1, t2, t3, t4 and t5. Means the first 5 terms of the given sequence. Next question. Find the first 3 terms of the following sequences of which Sn means sum of first n terms is given here. Sn is equal to 5 in bracket twice n minus 1. Sn is equal to n in bracket twice n plus 1. Sn is equal to n cube plus 2. Sn is equal to n square into n plus 1 bracket square upon 4. Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 upon 6. In all these examples, firstly find out S1, S2 and S3 by putting the value of n is equal to 1, 2 and 3, and using the Tn's formula, Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1 means T1 is equal to S1, T2 is equal to S2 minus S1 and T3 is equal to S3 minus S2. Using this formula, find out the first 3 terms of the sequence. My next topic is, what is the arithmetic progression, means AP. For this question, there are some activities. This is the picture of human pyramid. First step is observe and explore. In this step, there are 2 pictures. One is the steps of success and second is the human pyramid. There is a constant pattern, means in 2 rows there are some constant fixed pattern from these pictures. Now second activity is in Nikhil deposit 5 rupee coin every per day as per the date in piggy bank. For example, 1 coin on first day, second coins on second day, third coins on third day and so on. How many coins does he will deposit on 22nd day of that month? Activity number 3, observe the following sequences and note down your observation. There are some collection of sequences, means there are sequences and observe these sequences and write down the our observation. From these activities, second step is define and to prove. In above all sequences, there is the some relationship between 2 consecutive terms, means the terms of the sequences, but in some sequences there is the same relation between the 2 consecutive terms. The difference between any term and its previous term remains the same. From these activities, we get the definition of the arithmetic progression, is AP. Arithmetic progression is the sequence of which its first term is given and each term is obtained by the adding the constant number. In this AP, the constant number is known as common difference. It is denoted by small letter d and the first term is denoted by small letter t. That means first term t1 is equal to small letter k, t2 means t1 plus common difference d, fixed number d, t3 is t2 plus d, t4 is equal to t3 plus d and tn is equal to tn minus 1 plus d. From this last step, b is equal to tn minus tn minus 1. Now, third step is apply and evaluate. There are some questions. Question number 1, which of the following sequences are AP or not? There are some sequences, some are AP and some are not AP. Question number 2, if the radii of circles are 2 cm, 4 cm, 6 cm, 8 cm, and so on, then the circumferences of circle are in AP or not. Means from the radar, find out the circumferences and verify the circumferences are in AP or not. Question number 3, there are some regular polygons. First is the equilateral triangle, second is the square, third is the regular pentagon, and in fourth, this is the regular hexagon. In all of these regular hexagon, the sides are equal. Question is, the perimeters or areas are in AP or not. This is the interesting example. Question number 4, find the next 3 terms of the AP. Find out the first term is given. Find the common difference, means the difference between any 2 consecutive terms, and find out the next 3 terms. Next example about temperature of the city. Temperature of the city is in a particular week is in an AP. The temperature on Sunday is 12 degrees Celsius. The temperature on Monday is 14 degrees Celsius. The temperature on Tuesday is 16 degrees Celsius. Find the temperature of next 3 days. These are temperatures are in AP. That means find out the common difference, and using that common difference, find out the temperature of next 3 days. Now, next topic is the general term of an arithmetic progression, means nth term of an AP. There are also 3 steps. This is the first step. For this first step, there are some activities. First is observe and explore. Activity number 1. There is the AP 5, 9, 13, 7. These numbers, how can express 5 express as 5, 9 express as 5 plus 4, 13 5 plus 4 plus 4, 17 5 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. 5 means 5 plus 0 into 4. 5 plus 4 means 5 into 1 into 4. 5 plus 4 plus 4 means 5 plus 2 into 4. And last, 5 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 means 5 plus 3 times into 4. Means 3 times 4. 5 is equal to 5 plus 0 into 4. 9 is equal to 5 into 1 into 4, 13 is equal to 5 plus 2 into 4, 17 is equal to 5 into 3 into 4. From these 4 examples, we get the general term TN. Means TN is equal to 5 is the first term in bracket 0, 9 is the second term in bracket 1. 13 is the third term in bracket 2, 17 is the fourth term in bracket 3. Means here this term number, TN means nth term, means in bracket n minus 1, means TN is equal to 5 plus in bracket n minus 1 into 4. Second activity, Veera starts his job with starting salary of rupees 25,000 per month, with annual increment of rupees 1,500. What will be the salary after 10 years? This is the example. Salary for first year is rupees 25,000. After 1 year, means salary for second year is rupees 25,000 plus 1,500. Means rupees 25,000 plus 1 into 1,500. This 1 multiple 1 can be write in bracket 2 minus 1. Means rupees 25,000 plus in bracket 2 minus 1 into 1,500. Salary for third year like this, rupees 25,000 plus in bracket 3 minus 1 into 1,500. Salary for fourth year, rupees 25,000 plus, there is a question mark in a bracket, means there is the difference which is 4 minus 1 into 1,500, and so on. The salary for 10 years is rupees 25,000 plus in bracket after 9 years means the salary for 10 years in bracket 10 minus 1 into 1500. Now next step is define and put. In and the given AP, if first term is given A, the common difference is D, then and the general term is Tn, then Tn is equal to the first term plus term number minus 1 into the common difference, means Tn is equal to A plus in bracket n minus 1 into D. This is the formula to find the general term, is nth term of the AP. Next step is apply and evaluate. Using the formula Tn, there are some questions. See the GeoGebra kit. Question is, in the coordinate system for any graph of the line, the x coordinates of the points are in AP, are the y coordinates of those points in AP or not? Look in this GeoGebra kit. This is the line having equation 12x plus y is equal to 6. This is the graph. This line is the graph of that equation. If we take any some points on this line having x coordinates are in AP, A minus 1 having x coordinate minus 1, B having x coordinate 1, point C with x coordinate 3, point D x coordinate is 5, point E x coordinate is 7. That means in the algebraic view, the x coordinates are minus 1, 1, 3, 5, 7. That means there is the common difference too. Means the x coordinate of these 5 points are in AP. First about the y coordinate. The y coordinates are in AP or not? There are also some questions. In this question, first term 4 is given, common difference D is given, find the 15th term is T15. AP is given 3, 8, 13, 18, find the Tn. Next, first term is given, 7th term is given, find the common difference. For an AP, 9th term is 2, 5th term is 2 and 9th term is minus 10, find the T11. There are some challenging examples are there for the students.